Taylor from the Friendship Factory, and welcome to the 25-day Christmas Craft Challenge, where we challenge you to make as many crafts as you can for your family and friends this holiday season. Please stay tuned to the end of this video for the chance to win the ultimate craft prize valued over $300 from the Friendship Factory. Before you get started, you'll need to go pick up some materials or use stuff from around the house. You will need some clothespins. You can get these from any of the crafting stores. You can get colored ones or just the wooden ones. You'll need an X-Acto knife. Make sure when you use this, you're very careful. They're super sharp. A Sharpie, pair of scissors, paint and a paintbrush. This is optional. You can also just use a bunch of colorful markers. Glue sticks and a hot glue gun, which you gotta be careful with too. A foam board. This foam board is 20 by 30, so you can get these at a craft store as well. You'll need a bigger plate and a smaller plate that kind of fits inside the plate. First step is to lay your foam board flat on the ground and take your big plate and place it upside down onto the foam board. As you can see, you can probably make three of these out of one. I'm just gonna try to make two today. So you're going to take your Sharpie, make sure if this is an important plate to your family member or someone you know, that you do not trace a plate with a Sharpie, find something else that you do. And then just trace along the outside, just like that, so you create a big circle. So now you have the two big circles. Place your smaller plate somewhere in the center. Try to make it exact if you can. And then just trace along the outside. It's pretty good. Next, I'm going to get out my paint and my paintbrush. And I'm going to put it in something that I can just squirt the paint in. So I'm just going to use a shoebox top. You can use a paper plate, whatever you choose. I'm going to squirt some of the paint in there. Make sure you are very clean with this and you don't get it all over your carpet or your wood floors. And I'm just going to paint inside the circle. If you get it a little outside the circle, that's okay. That's why I like to do it while it's on the board still instead of cutting it out first. Is to take your small plate after everything is dried and place it over the smaller circle. Then take your X-Acto knife, make sure that your foam board is over top of something that you're able to cut through. So I put another piece of cardboard underneath of here. And then you're going to very carefully take your time and trace the plate with the X-Acto knife. You want to go slow so that you actually get a perfect circle. You have the center cut out, just like this. It's going to be kind of rough around the edges, so you can sand it down and you can take a Sharpie and color around the edge so that it looks really nice. And then you're just going to place your big plate around the circle and do the same thing with the X-Acto knife where you trace the plate around carefully and cut out the rest of the circle. Now we have this perfect circle, and if you have a bunch of frayed edges because the styrofoam is a little bit unruly, all you have to do is take some sandpaper to it and smooth around the edges, and you can take your X-Acto knife and cut off all the little frayed ends. Mine definitely wasn't perfect when I got finished with mine. So then you can like paint around the outside if you don't like the white around the edge, but I don't mind it because the pins are gonna be all around it. So you're ready for the next step. Now you're going to make sure that you have your clothespins ready, your glue gun is warmed up, and you have extra sticks right by you, and you have a bunch of pictures picked out for your board. You're going to take the clothespin, and the end that does not open up, you are going to glue this all the way around the board, just like I did this one, and leave a little bit of a space, but make sure you can go ahead in the center and open and close that clip. Leave about this much space in between each one. Your picture board should look something like this once you're finished, and it should just have a bunch of different spaces in it. You can write really cute quotes in the middle of here if you want to, or just leave it blank. And you can draw little pictures on there too. Now you just add your pictures. So you pick up your pictures and you place them wherever you want on the board. I cut out some really cute flowers for mine, so you can do that as well. You just keep placing everything on the board wherever you want. The coolest thing about this board is it doesn't have to be a picture board. You can make it into a to-do list, so you can clip all of your to-dos on here. You can also make it for someone special and put all of the reasons why you love them on it. There's many different things you can do with this. It's super cool. This is what mine ended up looking like, and I bet yours is really beautiful too. Make sure you post your photo below if you end up making this project. Mine looks so amazing on my bedroom wall. I'm really happy with it, and I hope you're happy with yours too. Make sure you make a bunch of these for your family and friends for Christmas. It's so simple and beautiful. It looks great. I love mine. And if you do make this, just post your photo below so we can see it. I hope you enjoyed the craft we made today. If you love crafting as much as we do, make sure you check out all of our Choose Friendship products. And to enter to win the ultimate craft prize valued over $300, just follow this link below. We wish you a very happy holiday season, and always choose friendship.